you were saying that you don't think anything happens after we die. It's just like kind of that's it. So I was curious if you A, changed your mind, or B, considered like maybe like a spiritual consequence of not dying.
I have not changed my mind. It seems absolutely self-evident to me that given what we know, that when you go, you go. Mm-hmm. Now, it's also self-evident to me that I don't know shit about it. So it is, you know, the great mystery of life to me is when you think about a house being built, that house has to be built on a plot of land. That plot of land is on Earth. Earth is, you know, in the cosmos. It is stuck in space-time. And space-time, I'm being asked to accept, is expanding. What's it expanding into? And, you know, when you think about that, and I've had people on the show that can explain sort of what that expansion is, and they will use the example of a balloon. And they'll say the universe that we exist in is like being stuck in the rubber layer of a balloon. So as the balloon expands, it's, you know, still the same amount of rubber, but it's just, you know, it's getting farther and farther. So if you had to cross one distance, that distance is now farther. Mm-hmm. And my thing is, cool, but what's the balloon in? Like the balloon is in something, some sort of space, hyperspace, other dimensions, whatever. Mm-hmm. And so because everyone just sort of gets to the point where they say something like higher dimensions or we don't know or whatever, mm-hmm. You're left with, have you heard that phrase turtles all the way down?
No.
Oh God, I love this story so much. So this to me is brilliant. And this is, I think, the state of quantum mechanics right now. So there was a person trying to explain to this old woman in a village, hey, the earth is round. And she was like, get out of here. The earth is obviously flat. You can see that it's flat. And the scientist, thinking that he's got her, asks her, well, if it's flat, what's it on? And she said, well, it's resting on the back of a gigantic turtle. And he's thinking, I got her now. And he goes, what's the turtle resting on? And she goes, don't be silly. Everybody knows it's turtles all the way down. And that's where we get is like, you just get into some sort of ultra recursive, like there is no answer, mm-hmm. right? To you either, even if you accept like a multi-universe theory or like a bubble universe theory where it's like, we're all these bubble universes in like this foam. Well, it's like, what's the foam in? Where'd the foam come from? Mm-hmm. Like, You ultimately get back to an I don't know. Mm-hmm. And because I fully accept that I get down to an I don't know. So I don't take any pride in saying that nothing happens after we die. I don't think I'm cool for saying, hey, nothing happens. It just seems wise to me to assume that nothing happens because there's nothing that I've seen that, like, if you know Phineas Gage, I don't know how people overcome the Phineas Gage problem. So Phineas Gage, like, 1890, whatever, he's working on the railroad. You wouldn't believe it. There are photos of, look him up, Phineas Gage. Mm. There are photos of him with the tamping rod. It's like 6 feet long or something ridiculous. Hits a tamping rod, shoots up under his, actually it's through his, right under his cheekbone, up through the top of his head and out. He loses a teacup's worth of brain matter, never loses consciousness. He literally vomits brain matter. Oh my God, it's so crazy. But does not lose consciousness. From that moment on is never the same. Everybody says he goes from like the most lovely guy to a total asshole, couldn't hold down a job, total nightmare to be around. So now I ask you, if all you had to do was fundamentally change his personality, is damage the physical structures of his brain, which version of him goes to heaven? The mm-hmm. damaged or undamaged version? And if it's the undamaged version, why? Why is it that his whole time on earth is fundamentally affixed to the physical nature of his brain? In fact, I don't even need to damage his brain. Let me just give him ecstasy. Mm. He will be a totally different person for a couple of hours. Let me give him massive amounts of acid, be a totally different person. So it seems so clear that we are the result of the physical structures and the neurochemistry of our brain. I just don't see why that would suddenly live beyond anything now. But again, I don't feel cool for saying that. Mm-hmm. It just like, just seems obvious. Now, are there spiritual implications to living forever? Yes, but now we would have to define spiritual. So to me, how you spend your life is a spiritual consideration. If you really believe mm-hmm. that if I put time and attention into getting good at something, and I can get good at anything I want, then how you spend your time is a spiritual consideration. What are you going to get good at? You're going to get good at helping people, building things, tearing things down, doing something for yourself, something for other people. Like, it all matters, right? Mm-hmm. And we're a wildly interconnected social species. So it's not like any of these choices are consequence-free.